Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 10th of 2019, well, it is titled Pluto in True Color. So what do we see here? Well, this is actually an image of Pluto as put together from a number of images taken by the New Horizons spacecraft. Now, the New Horizons craft flew by Pluto back in July of 2015 and gave us our first and only close-up view of this dwarf planet. And it was, of course, a great surprise to astronomers because we did not know what to expect. Even with the most powerful telescopes here on Earth, looking at like things with the Hubble Space Telescope, we could see that there were lighter and darker areas, but we could not see any kind of detail. And that's because of the immense distance and small size of Pluto. There was simply no way to really see any kind of detail on its surface. So until New Horizons flew by, we really didn't know exactly what to expect. And of course, as I say, there were some surprises there. We see a number of different areas. We see, for example, a number of craters labeled here. So we can see a bunch of different cratered regions and some very specific craters that look that are impacts just like we get here on Earth, on our own moon, and on any other object with a solid surface. So we know that Pluto does have a solid surface, unlike, of course, the gas giant planets, which would not show any craters because they don't have a solid surface on which to leave craters. Craters are due to impacts of other objects that smash into it, digging out an area on the object. So here, and the other thing we have to consider is that we do see these craters, but these craters are not like lunar craters. These are all dug into ice. Pluto is composed almost all of ice, and certainly its surface is completely icy with things like frozen nitrogen making up a large percentage of its surface. Now, we also see a couple of the other regions highlighted here. The large, lighter colored area, kind of in a heart shape noted here, is the Tombaugh Regio. And that is a lighter region. And within it, we also see the very smooth region known as Sputnik Planitia. And that is a very unexpectedly smooth. Now, why is it unexpected that a region is smooth? Well, we use craters to tell how old something is. The more cratered an object is, the longer that portion of the surface has been exposed to space. And a smooth area just means that it's relatively new. It had to have formed recently because any craters would have been wiped out, and it hasn't been there long enough to have formed new craters. On our moon, we have the Highlands, which are heavily cratered, and the Maria, which are lightly cratered. But here we see an entire region with very few or no craters on it, meaning that it had to have formed recently. Now, why is that a surprise? Well, Pluto is out in the depths of space, very far away from the sun. It's very small, so it was not expected that it would be active, that it would have any kind of activity or material on its surface that was able to move. On Earth, we'd have volcanic activity, molten rock flowing up and filling in any craters that formed over geological timescales. On other planets and moons, we have similar things to varying extents, and therefore we see varying numbers of craters. So somehow we know that Pluto has been active as well, having icy volcanoes or icy flows of lava that would then fill out and form this area, that we're able to fill in this area. So we don't completely understand, but we do know, looking at regions like this, that Pluto has had some activity in some of its regions in the relatively recent past. So we continue to study the images sent back by New Horizons, this one being specifically processed to register what would be seen by the human eye. So essentially a true color image. What would Pluto look like if you could actually go out there and look at it yourself? So that was our picture of the day for September the 10th of 2019. It was titled Pluto in True Color. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be a big heart. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.